press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hello children, how are you? I hope that all are doing good. So today I am here with you with new chapter. The name of the chapter is The Monkey and the Crocodile. So this lesson is very different. Okay, why it is very different? Because the story is about animals and their friendship. Okay, so here there are two friends, that is monkey and the crocodile. So let's see how their friendship began and how it is going to be an end. Okay, so let's see here. A monkey lived in a fruit tree on the bank of a river. Okay, so this monkey, it is living living in a bank of a river, which is a fruit tree. Okay, the fruit tree here the name of the fruits are not mentioned, but that monkey is living in a fruit tree. Okay, living on a fruit tree. Then it is on a bank of river. He made friends with the crocodile, gave him delicious fruits to eat, and sent some for his wife. Okay, so this monkey, which is living on this tree, so when he become a friend of the crocodile, so he always gave the fruits to the crocodile, and some of the fruits he just sent to his wife. Okay, whose wife? Crocodile's wife. Okay, then they met regularly and talked, the monkey in the tree and the crocodile on the ground. So whenever they used to meet, okay, when this monkey and the crocodile, they used to meet, so what they do, they having always a nice talk. Okay, so monkey which is on the tree, how they were talking, the monkey which is on the tree and this crocodile, it is on the ground. Okay, so like this way their friendship has begun. So let's see here. Once on the bank of a river, a monkey made a home for himself in a tree laden with fruit. Okay, and he lived in it happily, eating to his heart's content the fruit of his choice. So once upon a time, on the bank of a river, the monkey it is living. Okay, and then he made a home there himself. Okay, he was made a home on a tree, then in a tree, then laden with fruits. There are so many fruits, delicious fruits were there in that tree. He lived in it happily, eating to his heart's content the fruit of his choice. So this monkey is living happily with his fruits. Okay, that fruits are contentment means it's a satisfaction. Satisfaction with the fruits. Okay, so like that, there's so much of delicious, that fruits of so much of delicious it has. So he is always, he just enjoying whenever he just eat it. Okay, then the monkey was happy but lonely and wanted a companion to talk to and share the fruits with. So this monkey, it is happy but it is alone. So he doesn't have anybody to talk with him. He feels that he needs some friend. Okay, so he feels alone on a tree and share some fruits with them. But there was no one on around, not even another monkey, till one day a crocodile appeared on the river side. So when he thought that he is alone, there is no other monkey on a, it is with him. So he thought that at least he could be any kind of animals. Just he wanted to talk with them, and then he just give those delicious fruits to those friends. Okay, at least one single friend. But one day what happened? The crocodile arrived on his place. Okay, the monkey's place. Till one day crocodile appeared on the river side. Okay, so one day, so the crocodile arrived to this river side. Hello, so crocodile here. Hello there, said the monkey. So now the first talk begin with the monkey. Okay, how he started conversation. Hello, here I am. Hello there, said the monkey. Do you live in this river? Would you like to eat some fruit? So monkey asked the question to crocodile. So would you, means you are living in this river? Would you want some of the fruits? Okay, so he like that, he asked the question to crocodile. Good morning, replied the crocodile politely. So this crocodile also respectfully, okay, politely means respectfully, he is also replied it. So what he said, good morning. He wished that, good morning, I did come here in search of food for myself and my wife. Yes, I came here to search the food. Okay, so for to whom? for myself and for my wife. I came here too in search of food. Nice of you to offer me fruit. So crocodile, he just saying thank you to the monkey. So you are offering fruits to me. So it is very nice one. It is very thankful about you. So he says. The monkey plucked some from the nearest branch and threw them down. So when this crocodile is also accepted that what the monkey is offering, that fruits. So this monkey was plucked. Plucked means he picked the fruits. Okay, some of the fruits which is in the nearest branch. And threw it down. And when he plucked it and he just threw it down. So where that crocodile, it was there. So he was thrown there. The crocodile found them delicious. Thanks, he said. May I have some on my next visit? So crocodile, he was very satisfied and he says to the monkey, I am very satisfied. And then he says, may I have some on my next visit? When I am coming to the next visit, may I get some of the other fruits? May I get the fruits? So he asked it. Certainly, as many as you like, and some for your wife too, said the monkey. So monkey also said to crocodile, yes, sure, as you like, you come anytime and you just take some of the fruits to your wife. So who said this? Monkey said to crocodile. Then, do come again. I am rather lonely here. So you come again. So he offered to come again and again, and because I am living alone here, I don't have any friends. So he just offering his friendship to crocodile. Then the crocodile visited the monkey regularly and ate the fruits which his host threw down. Okay, so this crocodile, when he heard that crocodile, so he always means he just regularly he used to come to the monkey. Okay, and this monkey regularly and ate the fruits which his host threw down. Host means who is the host here? Monkey is the host. Okay, because this crocodile is a kind of a friend and a guest to this monkey. So he is hosting him. Okay, so he is welcoming with the entertainment, with the fruits and with the food and all. So he is a hosting. Okay, so monkey is a host here. He took some home for his wife. So crocodile, he took some of the fruits to his wife. The monkey and the crocodile were now the best of friends. So now the day passes. So both of them, the monkey and the crocodile, they become a best friends. Okay, so they have a fun with each other and they were talking nicely. And the monkey is also, he is very kind and he just offering fruits to him, not only to crocodile and to his wife also. Okay, then they talked and were never tired of talking. So both of them, they were talking and they would never get tired. Okay, so like this, they talked about birds and animals, about the villages nearby and the difficulties villagers faced in raising good crops for lack of rain. So what they were talking, both of them, the crocodile and the monkey, so they were talking about some animals, some birds and the villagers. Then the people of the villagers, they were facing the problems, okay, because of the lack of the rain, because they not get good crops. Okay, so based on that they were having a nice talk. Okay, these are the topics, these are the discussions. So they were talking here. One day the crocodile stayed with the monkey longer than usual. So one day what happened, this crocodile, he was staying with the monkey for a long time. Okay, so usually how much time he was staying with them? One day he was stayed for very long time. Okay, then his wife was annoyed, waiting, managing the little crocodiles that had just been hatched. So this crocodile, he was enjoying the company of monkey, but at home the crocodile's wife, so she was annoyed. Annoyed means she gets irritated because her husband has not came her home early. Okay, so that's why, because waiting, she has to take care of the small crocodiles babies, which is now they have hatched. Hatched means coming out of the eggs. Those crocodiles children, they came out from the eggs now. Okay, she can't manage them. Okay, so she was annoyed. See, what an interesting thing. So here the crocodile is also having the family, and the monkey needs a friendship. Okay, so where it is happening? In the human beings, among the human beings it is happening. But you can see here how the story goes. Okay, the story goes to the animals' world. We can imagine, because it is not in reality, but it is an imagination. Okay, so imagine that how the crocodiles and monkeys, they are having a conversation, how the crocodile, he has his family. Okay, then she said, "Who is this friend of yours you are so fond of?" So when this crocodile went home, the wife, she questioned him. "So what? So who is this? Who is this friend of you of your? So which is, are you fond of him?" Okay, fond means attracted. You are attracted too much of that friend. Who is this your friend? So this wife is asked to her husband. "Oh, he is very nice monkey," he replied. So crocodile replied, "He is very nice monkey. He is very good monkey. Then he lives on a fruit tree. He sends fruits for you every day. You don't expect me to climb trees, do you? See, daily what I am bringing to you, the fruits are, so that monkey he is offering for you. Do you think I can climb the tree? No, that monkey is giving me fruits to give you." Okay, so like that, the crocodile is appreciating the quality of monkey. "A nice monkey, I am sure," replied the wife with obvious sarcasm. Sarcasm means evident mocking fun of him. So the wife, after listening these words from her husband, the wife, she said like this, "Yes, a nice monkey, I am sure, but she said also obvious sarcasm. Okay, obvious sarcasm, she was laughing by saying that sentence. Okay, she was laughing and having fun with that monkey. "If you ask me, this monkey should be my food. If you ask me means here wife is asking to husband. Okay, who the crocodile wife, crocodile's wife, she is asking to the crocodile, "If you ask me, okay, food, so that monkey, he is going to be my food." See, what a selfish wife she is. Regularly, the crocodile, he is bringing some of the fruits which has given by the monkey, and he is giving to his wife. And now, after listen the monkey's thing, monkey story, so she is offering that monkey should be her food. Okay, the monkey should be her food. Means she wanted to kill the monkey and eat it. "I want to eat his heart so much. So what I wanted to eat? I wanted to eat that monkey's heart." So whose desire it is? That wife desire. Okay, the crocodile's wife desire it is. "What a foolish thing to say," shouted the crocodile. See, crocodile, he was not like his wife. Okay, so he was shouted. "So what a foolish thing you are saying." He was get angered. Okay, then, "I can't kill a friend, though I won't mind a monkey occasionally for a change of taste." So now he says, I don't want to kill my friend. I don't want to change my taste. Because of my taste, I can't kill my friend. Do you think that I am going to kill him? Like that. "You bring him here," ordered the wife. "I want to see him." You know how the crocodile's family are. Okay, crocodile, it is very cruel animal. Okay, it is not living any single, either it may be the animal or it may be the human being, they will never live. So here the wife has same qualities what the crocodile they have. Okay, crocodiles they have. But this crocodile means the here her husband, okay, who has bet to the monkey. So he is not like his wife, okay, because when he met with that monkey, he changed his characters, his quality, because he is offering fruits. Then why should he kill him? But this wife is not like that husband, okay. So like this one, and he got here wife ordered him, "Just bring him here, bring him that monkey." Okay, then, "See, you can eat him?" "Never," declared her husband. "So are you going to eat him?" So the husband were declared, no, you are never going to eat him. Okay, like this. Then what happened in the next? Let's see. His wife was furious. Furious means she was get very angered. Okay, it's not a normal anger. She was got too much of anger. And she dived in to hide herself at the bottom of the river, leaving the little ones to pester their father. Okay, so when she has heard that what the husband was saying, so she was went down, she was dive under the water, and she was left the small babies towards that father. Okay, pester means trouble. They were troubling that small kids, they were troubling to the crocodile. Okay, so she left there and she went down under the water and she was living there. Okay, the crocodile was in a serious dilemma because his wife was get angered, and now he wanted to fulfill the desire of his wife, but how he can kill his friend? So now he is in dilemma. So dilemma means he is in a difficulty to take a decisions. Okay, so what kind of a decision he has to take? Either he should agree the wife words, or he could follow the friendship. He can continue the friendship with the monkey. Okay, so like this, he loved his wife and was very fond of his friend too. So the two sides, like he loved his wife too much, and he was excuse me, this crocodile is very attracted to this monkey also. Then how can he fulfill these two people desire? Okay, and this wife desire, and he can't kill the monkey. Okay, then finally he decided to be on the side of his wife at last. So this crocodile decided he should be agree the what wife says. Okay, he should follow the what the wife says. Okay, she was his life partner after all. She is a life partner, means till the death this crocodile, okay, this wife, she is with this crocodile and not this monkey. Okay, so this is, and next what happened here? I know it's a sin to betray a friend, but I have no choice, he said to himself. So now the crocodile, he said to himself that it is a crime that I can betray. Means here unfaithful. Okay, I should be unfaithful towards my friend. So it is a sin, but I don't have any choice. I have to do this, okay, for my wife. So like this, he said to himself, I will invite the monkey home and hope for the best. So one day he decided himself, so I will call monkey to my home, and then let's see what will happen. So like this, he has decided. My wife wants you over for a meal, dear friend, said the crocodile when he visited the monkey next. You must come home with me today. Okay, so now this crocodile, he said like this to monkey, my wife is going to prepare a meal for you, so today you come with me, and she is going to offer a meal for you. Okay, you must come home with me today. So that day has decided. So when this crocodile planned how to call this monkey to his wife. Okay, with pleasure, said the monkey. So now the monkey is very happy because he is living alone on the tree. Okay, then he should go with the friend because he is trusting him, because regularly they both were talking nicely with each other, and he knows very well. So he was very happy. He was in a pleasure that he is accepted the what the crocodile said. Okay, I'm no swimmer, but can ride on your back. And they set out. I'm not a good swimmer. I don't know how to swim, but I can come to you on your back. So this monkey said. The sentence should be said by monkey. In the middle of the river, where the current was the strongest, the crocodile could no longer hide his intention. Okay, so now in the middle of the river. So when they were on their journey, okay, so then in the middle of the river, so where the water is filled, okay, so there is no there is no chance to escape from the water and the river to the monkey. So there he can't hide his intention. So what is the intention? He wanted to share with the friend. Who said this? Crocodile decided. Then, sorry my friend, he said hesitatingly. Now crocodile said to monkey, sorry my friend. Okay, he accepted that whatever he is doing, that is sorry. With the shyness, hesitatingly means with the shyness, he said sorry to the monkey. But I have to go underwater now. I have brought you here to kill you. Now I want to go under the water. I just call someone to kill you. He said like this. My wife cannot survive without eating your heart. Goodbye. Like this sentence he said. My wife desire, he can't live without killing you. She needs your heart. So friend, I will be back. Goodbye, he said, and he went. Then next what happened? Let's see here. The monkey was scared and distressed. See, after listening these words, the monkey was scared. He was get fear. He feels very distressed. He is in tension. How can he escape from this situation? His friend has betrayed him. Okay, so like he was cheated him, the crocodile. So he was trusted him. So that's why he has cheated. Okay, then. But he was sensible and clever like all monkeys. But this monkey is very sensible and he's clever too. He's very smart like all the monkeys. He's not a stupid. Although he is living alone, so he's not a stupid here. Then he kept a cool head. Calmly, he said, I would do anything for you and your family. So just for a while, he just be a calm. He was relaxed. Then he was started thinking. And next he said to crocodile, okay, I'll ready to do anything for you. Okay, so this was said by monkey to crocodile. You are my only friend after all. What is a monkey's heart compared with the life of a crocodile's wife? Like that he questioned, he asked the question to crocodile. Although I'm a monkey, I'm a lonely monkey. Okay, I'm lonely monkey, but like comparing to my heart. So what is the big thing? So your wife is going to be satisfied. My heart is not it's not a great thing for me. Okay, I can get ready to kill myself. Okay, then. But how foolish could you be? Why didn't you tell me before then? Why don't you tell me before? How foolish you are, he said to crocodile like this. The monkey said, crocodile to like this. He asked the question. I would have brought my heart along. So I don't have my heart here. If you say early to me, I would have to bring my heart along with me. Like that, this monkey is very wise. He thought, in his talent, in his cleverness, he said this crocodile, his heart is in a tree. Okay, so he could go there and he could bring it. Okay, then. But where is your heart? Asked the crocodile innocently. So innocently, this crocodile asked monkey, where is your heart? I thought you carried it all the time. So crocodile, how foolish this crocodile is. The crocodile is asking that, I thought that you are carrying your heart all the time. So that's why you have kept it there? So he asked. Of course not. It's there on the tree. So monkey said, of course not. I am not carrying this heart along with me. It is on a tree. Let's swim back at the once and get it. So see how this clever monkey it is. So he just decided to get away from this situation. Okay. So then he said to crocodile, it is on the tree. Just we will go back there and we will bring it here. Okay. So like that he said that. Your wife must be waiting, replied the monkey, gaining confidence. Maybe your wife is waiting there he has to win the confidence, no? The monkey, the crocodile's confidence, because he has to understand the monkey's what he says, with not only by believing, and he should be get the confidence of this crocodile. And again he added the word called, your wife is waiting there, so we will go there, okay? In a very hurriedly, we will get back to the tree and then we will bring the heart. Okay, then. The next one happened. Of course not. Of course not. It's, okay. Oh dear, what a mistake, hissed the crocodile. Oh dear, what you have done? Why you left your heart there? Okay, so like this, the crocodile says. They laughed loudly as the crocodile took a full turn to reach the tree. The both of them, they will laugh together when the crocodile it is near to reach the tree. Okay, so now the crocodile got foolish. He just took this monkey towards the tree, and now they are near to the tree. Okay, then what happened? On the river bank, the monkey jumped onto the tree and heaved a deep sigh of relief. So when they went near the tree, and now this monkey was jumped on the tree, and now he was given a deep sigh. Deep sigh means the face, he given a sign, symbol, like he was in a relief. Oh my God, like this we will sigh if we are get rid of some of the problems. So how we express ourselves? Oh my God, what a trouble, what a problem it was. Is it like that? He was in a relief. Okay, then who? That monkey. He plucked a fruit or two from the nearest branch and throwing them down said, "Let your wife have some fruit rather than my hand." Then suddenly, when he was jumped on the tree and he plucked some of the fruits and he thrown some of the one or two fruits to down, and he said there, "Let give your wife this fruits are. He should be need this fruits, not my heart." He said like this. "Fresh fruits are good for mind and body. Goodbye, friend. And if you don't mind, we won't meet again. See." So fresh fruits are good for your mind, good for mind and body. Not the someone's heart is good when you kill someone, not the heart is good. What the good things are? Fruits. So it is good for your health and body. And let's see, again he says, "Goodbye, my friend." He says goodbye to his friend, that is crocodile, and he says that, don't mind that once we will not meet again, okay? We won't meet again. The crocodile, sadder and wiser, shed a few tears which were genuine and turned back to home, to go home. Now the crocodile was crying. So on his eyes there was tears. So it was a sadder. This crocodile was sadder and wiser too, and shed a few drops of tears which were genuine. Genuine means it was very loyal. So when he was cried for monkey, so he's crying very deep heartedly. Okay, that is genuine. It is not a fake one. It is a truly in a love of his friend. Okay, because he lost that friend then in his life, and that friend it will never come back again. Okay, he was in a hurry to tell his wife a thing or a two. Okay, the story from the Panchatantra. Okay, so now he is in a hurry to say the story. He went to his wife. So this is the story here. It is going to be an end. And so what the moral we will get in from this lesson? So friendship is very precious actually. Okay, either it is in animals or in human beings. So the friendship is very pure. It is very precious. Okay, like a pearls, gems, how those stones were, like that. Okay, do not let it spoil because of someone's greed. So don't spoil a friendship because of the someone's greediness. Okay, if you feel that there because of the some person I am losing my best friend, so don't betray your friend. Okay, so for the greediness means desire. Okay, so this is, we should not trust anyone blindly. And another one thing is, we should not trust anyone blindly. We should have to, because this monkey was, he was trusted and he went along with this crocodile. So there the story turns. Okay, he trusted a lot, but what the crocodile did, he was betrayed because of his wife. So there the story turns, when he said why, for what sake this crocodile is taking to his home. So then the story turns, and now this monkey is very wise, and now he wanted to get away from this problem. So he think like this way, and he was came out, and now the friendship was broken, and he was, his desire, he should not, his wishes, he should not meet once again in his life. Okay, so like this way the story ends. So the friendship is very precious. We need to preserve it and not spoil that friendship because of someone's greed, and we should not trust anyone blindly. Okay, so this is the moral of this lesson. So I hope that you all are enjoyed this story. Okay, so we will learn some of the lesson from the not only the story we are learning, and at the end we'll learn the moral from the story. Okay, so we will meet in the next class. Till then, all of you stay home, stay safe, keep learning. Thank you.